Good afternoon. The dignitaries on the dais, Honorable Minister for Information Technology and Electronics, Finance, Industry, Commerce and Enterprises, and Micro, Small and Medium Enterprises and Textile, Government of West Bengal, Dr. Amit Mitraji, Honorable Minister of Post, Telecommunication and IT, Government of the People's Republic of Bangladesh, Honorable Sri Mustafa Jabbarji, the guest of honor, Dr. Bhaskar Ghosh, Group CEO, Accenture Technology Services, Sri Amitabh Ray, MD Ericsson India Global Services Private Limited, Sri Kamal Nath, CEO, Sifi Technologies, Sri D.D. Purkayastha, MD and CEO, ABP Limited, and Chairman, INFOCOM, Sri M.K. Kemu, Regional Manager and Zonal Manager, LIC, esteemed delegates from IT industry from all across the country, experts from the field of information technology, delegates. It's my proud privilege to be part of this INFOCOM 2018, which we are basically organizing with ABP Limited. And I have been very fortunate to be part of this event over a period of time. And I have learned a lot from this kind of deliberation that has been happening every year for last many, many years. In fact, if you look at the whole ambition of INFOCOM 2018, it has aspired and decided to talk around a theme, when digital becomes human. And this is very ambitious, you know, statement, particularly for the kind of geography we belong to. And I must say that I must congratulate the esteemed IT industry of India, which has given this foundation, which has encouraged the stakeholders of today to be bold enough, to aspire enough, and to be encouraged enough to do better things for the future. In fact, IT industry of India, which started about 3 decades before, has been able to, you know, kickstart and trigger a great transformation in this country. Obviously, because of a kind of benchmark it has set, a kind of work culture it has brought to India, and the kind of opportunity, ecosystem, and atmosphere it has created within this country. In fact, if you look at the profile of IT industry, about 4 million engineers who are working all across the value chains are not merely driving and delivering the products for their customers, but they are also, you know, nurturing a lot of talent which is being used and capitalized by the stakeholders of the day to promote Digital India Initiative, Startup India Initiative, and to aspire and have ambition to become the world leader over a period of time. Today, we aspire to become 1 trillion economy only in the field of ICT. This is the kind of ambition the stakeholders, means governments of the day, the market forces, the enterprises put together are dreaming this kind of economy in this country. And it is merely because of the talent that we have in India. Because IT industry in India has been basically capitalized and established on the Indian talent. And because of outsourcing model is merely a transfer of job for a cost. And that is how, if you look at the profile today, about 56% of the total outsourcing global market is the Indian share in the whole thing, which comes around, which is translated into the $126 billion export, which has been registered in the year 2017-18. It's a very ambitious number. But hidden behind this number is a great potential, which I am trying to say is that capitalizing on the whole ecosystem that we have, which is primarily based on outsourcing model, India is aspiring to become the capital of the startup in the world. And today, if we started just before few years, and now we, as per KPMG report, we stand 3rd rank in the global innovation technology leader. And India is really aspiring. And I must congratulate all the stakeholders, Government of India, concerned state governments, industry partners, the philanthropists, the industry leaders, IT industry veterans, who are coming out, devoting their time and motivating, mentoring a lot of startups. If you look at India is now home to about 4,200 startups. But as per any statistics, the 12 companies which have been homegrown, they have contributed about 700 startups, exhibiting a kind of trend that India is witnessing today, that startups are also further fueling the creation of a startup. And you will be, you know, very happy. And I think you are the part of the whole ecosystem, that this movement, this kind of journey that is being undertaken, fueled, powered by the strong IT services industry in India, is going to make India a home of all sorts of R&D that is going to happen. We are already, you know, largest destination for R&D outsourcing. And the only need of the day was to create our own ecosystem and create and ideate and create our own products. And that is happening. It is very encouraging. If you look at the, you know, total, you know, profile that India has right now, it footprints India has right now in the world. Indian IT industry is present in 80 countries of the world, in 200 cities of the world, with 680 plus delivery centers. We are serving about 40 plus languages of the world. That's a very amazing number. And as I said, the IT industry has moved up the value chain. And right now, it is home. I mean, we all know that the quantum chip of Intel, ambitious program, it is happening only in Bangalore. And that is why the talent of India is able to power, deliver that kind of product for all across the world. And that is very encouraging and very aspiring for all the stakeholders present. I must say that the Government of India has taken a lot of initiative during the last 5 years. Digital India Initiative, Make in India Initiative, Startup India Initiative, also India BPO Promotion Scheme, just to disperse the, you know, BPO industry in a smaller town and country. And all these initiatives which are being coupled with the initiatives of the concerned state governments, like I would like to cite the initiative that Government of West Bengal has taken. They are establishing Silicon Valley, almost 12 IT parks all across the country, and we are joining hands with them. And you will be very happy to know that the largest, highest investment that STPI has made during its lifetime has been made in only in Salt Lake of Calcutta, where we are investing 120 crore in a single project to create a startup ecosystem, to create fab lab, data center, incubator, and to support micro and small medium enterprises who can come venture in our incubation center and could deliver their services to their customers. That the kind of, if you look at the, you know, Honorable Prime Minister of India, what he says, he laid the emphasis that promote and include the Eastern India in the growth journey. And based on those focus, we are trying our level best to, you know, make sure that we prioritize our investment, our focus in the Eastern India. And that is how this Salt Lake IT Center, STPI's IT Center, will power entire Northeast sitting here. And that is how it will become gateway of delivery of services, technology services, entrepreneurial promotion services through Kolkata. Kolkata has a lot of talent. You know, it used to be, you know, manufacturing hub of the past. And I must congratulate ABP for really, you know, providing this kind of platform for last many years, where a lot of experts, several experts, come from all across the country and they deliver their vision, which is further fueling the whole process of ideation across the manpower that we have in this country. I must say that IT industry has been chosen to be one of the champion sectors that Government of India has identified. And very soon you will see so many initiatives by the government to promote this sector further. IT industry of India has brought brand equity, and I must congratulate you all for the hard work that you have done. Great ethics, great work, great benchmarks, and great kind of, you know, work culture. And I must say that the whole talent that we have today in the IT industry has been able to use to be capitalized by the governments of the day to create future ambitions and future programs. With this, I must not take much time. I must say that I must thank and express my gratitude to ABP for affording this great opportunity to STPI to be part of the whole ecosystem that taking shape, and for affording opportunity to me also personally to share my views and to benefit from the kind of deliberation that is happening for law, for that is going to happen for another 2 days. Thank you very much.